All right, my friends, it is Sideways Stories from Wayside School time, and we are doing chapter 11 called Dana. There she is. I like her glasses. I have some that are just like it. I also think I have that skirt. And that says 3 bites plus 3 bites equals 6 bites. All right, Dana. Dana had 4 beautiful eyes. She wore glasses. But her eyes were so beautiful that glasses only made her prettier. With 2 eyes, she was pretty. With 4 eyes, she was beautiful. With 6 eyes, she would have been even more beautiful. And if she had had 100 eyes all over her face, her arms, and her feet, why, she would have been the most beautiful creature in the world. But poor Dana wasn't covered in head to foot with beautiful eyes. She was covered in mosquito bites. Mrs. Jules picked up her yardstick and said, "Now it's time for arithmetic." "Oh, no, Mrs. Jules," said Dana. "I can't do arithmetic. I itch all over. I can't concentrate." By the way, that totally is a real thing. Like, when I get too many mosquito bites, it's literally all I think about. They're just so itchy. "But we have all kinds of arithmetic," said Mrs. Jules. "Addition without carrying, addition with carrying, carrying without addition." "I don't care," cried Dana. "We have that too," said Mrs. Jules. "Addition without carrying. Now stop carrying on," Dana whined. "I can't, Mrs. Jules. I itch too much." "And I'm too thirsty," said DJ. "I'm too tired," said Ron. "I'm too hungry," said Terrence. "I'm too stupid," said Todd. Mrs. Jules hit her desk with the yardstick and everybody stopped talking. Mrs. Jules said, "We are going to have arithmetic now, and I don't want to hear another thing about it." "But Mrs. Jules, I really do itch. I can't do arithmetic," Dana whined. "I'm like itching, but I don't really itch." That's not in the book, but... sorry. "Miss Jules, I really do itch. I can't do arithmetic," Dana whined. "No," said Mrs. Jules. "Arithmetic is the best known cure for an itch. How many mosquito bites do you have?"
"I don't know,"
said Dana. "Over 100. First I try scratching one, and then another one starts to itch, so I scratch that one, and that one stops, and another one starts, so I scratch that one, and then the itch moves down to the other one, and then it goes back to the first one, and the itch just never stays in the same place, and I can't scratch them all." "What you need is a good, strong dose of arithmetic," said Mrs. Jules.
"I'd rather have calamine lotion," said Dana.
"Remember, Dana," said Mrs. Jules, "mosquito bites itch, not numbers."
"So what?" said Dana.
"So all you have to do is turn your mosquito bites into numbers," Miss Jules said.
"I'm a mess," Dana moaned.
Mrs. Jules began to turn the mosquito bites into numbers. "How much is 3 mosquito bites plus 3 mosquito bites? She asked. Rondi raised her hand.
6 mosquito bites, she answered.
"And how much is 6 mosquito bites minus 2 mosquito bites? Asked Miss Jules.
4 mosquito bites, said DJ.
"And how much is 5 mosquito bites times 2? Asked Mrs. Jules.
10 mosquito bites, said BB.
"Very good."
"I still itch," Dana complained.
"I've got one more question," said Mrs. Jules. "How much is 49 mosquito bites plus 75 mosquito bites? Nobody raised a hand. "Think, class." "Sorry," said Mrs. Jules. "This is for Dana." Nobody got the answer, and Dana's itch began to get worse and worse. At last, Dana began counting her own mosquito bites. She counted 75 on one side and 49 on the other. She added them together for a total of 124 mosquito bites.
124 mosquito bites, Dana called.
"Very good," said Mrs. Jules. Dana had 124 mosquito bites, and none of them itched anymore.
"I'm still thirsty," said DJ. "Can we do arithmetic for that?"
"I'm still tired," said Ron.
"I'm still hungry," said Terrence.
"I'm still stupid," said Todd.
"I'm glad we turned my mosquito bites into numbers instead of letters," said Dana. "I could never spell mosquito."
Can you spell mosquito? That's the end of the chapter. Love you, bye.